This is the combustion process. The whole detail for the syllabus what I mean is the lecture content briefly given through the YouTube. So please refer to the YouTube frequently. So which is actually we're going to look for the theoretical of the combustion process, and then the calculation for first law of the combustion process, which is we're going to calculate what will be the rate of heat transfer or the amount of the heat produced from the combustion process. Okay, so this is a combustion involving with the two mixture of component, which is oxidizer and the fuel. Oxidizer coming from the air, which is from the oxygen, it required oxygen, and then fuel, it can be from the the liquid, gas, or solid fuel. Liquid fuel, for example, the octane, your gasoline, petrol, and then gases like, for example, methane gas. And then solid like coal. Okay, so it is a mixture with the component, and then one of the important criteria to find is the mole fraction. Okay, so the detail I give you through the YouTube too, which is the mole fraction is the number of the individual component of the mole mole divided by the mixture mole, and then the mass fractions, which is calculation of the molecular weight, and then this is the gas mixture the mixture gas constant, which is equal to universal gas constant divided by the molecular mass. So the numbers that gas constant that you have, for example, for the dry air, which is coming from the calculation of molar mass for the air, which is 28.97, and then which is given by R equal to 8.314 divided by 28.97. Okay. And then this is the ideal gas law of mixture, which is you can use the Dalton's law and Amagat's law. Okay. So the theoretical definition of the combustion, which is a chemical reaction during which is a fuel is oxidized and a large energy. So this is the theoretical aspect of the combustion process, and then the dry air is consists of the 20.9% of the oxygen, 78.92% of nitrogen. So if you divide 78.1 divided by 20.9, so which means that which is equal to 3.736, which is actually, so which is for 1 kmol of O2, there will be in the dry air consists of 1 kmol of O2 plus 3.76 kmol of N2. So ni ada. So this is a self ignition temperature. So any of you have heard about the self ignition temperature? Ada pernah dengar tak sebelum ni? Ada tak? Tak pernah. Okay. So the self ignition temperature ni, which is It is common happen dalam in the high compression engine. Yeah. So it is due to the self ignition of the fuel when it achieve at high temperature. So if you can imagine from the four stroke engine, which is involving with the this is a piston, okay, so this is this is a piston, then you have the this is a cylinder and this is a piston where the piston will move up and down, which is produce the Otto cycle. So and as well the diesel cycle. So this is the Otto cycle. This is a volume and this is the temperature. Okay. So which is from the bottom dead center up to the top dead center. So bottom dead center will be the largest volume for the cylinder for the combustion chamber. So this is the BDC and this is the TDC. Okay. So from TDC, this is the intake stroke, and then you have a compression stroke, and then combustion stroke. Okay, combustion stroke, and then you have the power stroke. Okay, and then you will have a this is a power stroke, and then this is the exhaust stroke, and then come back to the intake stroke. Okay, so something like that. Yeah. So during the compression stroke, as you can see here, during due to the PV, the power of gamma equal to constant, so the temperature will be increased. So when the temperature is increased in the compression stroke, if it is exceeding of this set ignition temperature, let's say that the fuel that you use is the gasoline, then before it achieve to the top dead center, there will be some of the fuel in this combustion chamber will be self ignite, yang mana dia akan terbakar sendiri, okay, tanpa dimasukkan dengan the spark from the spark plug, okay, from the plug. So with that, this is early combustion. So this, when the combustion is produced, the pressure also will be increased in that certain area. In that, kalau let's say that it is happen here, the pressure also will be increased in that. So this combustion with the increment of the pressure will produce a knocking condition. Okay, it will create like something like if you remember, if you do the popcorn, if you cook a popcorn, the sounds is like a popcorn. Yeah, it's a pop 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 sounds, which is it can create a pressure wave in that location and propagate the early combustion process. So this is not good for the engine, as it will increase the pressure in the combustion chamber and will break the engine. So here is the sum of the self ignition temperature for the sum of the fuel, like for example the gasoline, the carbon, and then hydrogen, carbon monoxide, and then the methane, where you can see here the methane, the self ignition temperature for the methane is quite high, which is about 630, which is nearly about 900 Kelvin. So the effect is that it will damage the engine. So this is a process of the combustion where the reactant, which is coming from the fuel, it combined with the oxygen and then produce the product, exhaust product, and plus the heat. So the number of atoms and mass of an element must be equal on the each side, but for the reactant and the product, but the number of moles of each element must not be equal. So this is referred to the balancing of the combustion chemical equation, which is from the reactant and the product, yeah, which is combined in the reaction chamber. So for a complete combustion, the combustion product only produce CO2, H2O, and N2. So remember, this is a complete combustion. For all, we call it as the theoretical air. So theoretical air, with the amount of the theoretical air, it will produce a complete combustion. Okay? So if it is happen with the incomplete combustion, then some of the element will be produced CO, and then maybe some of the HOH and as well increase the H2O. Okay. So if air is used instead of concentrated oxygen in the reactant, okay, so this is the mole of oxygen in the air will be accompanied by 3.76 kilomole of the nitrogen that I have mentioned before. So C3H8, for example, plus 5O2 plus 3.7. This is required with the chemical balance. So which is I will combine later on when we do the combustion analysis. Yeah. And then this is another variable that you need to find. This is another parameters. Air to fuel ratio. So air to fuel ratio is the ratio between the mass of air divided by the mass of fuel, or sometimes it can be called as the FA, which is mass of fuel divided by mass of air. So if you are doing engine modeling or engine analysis in the future, this is what they call as AFR, air to fuel ratio. Dalam industri dia kira AFR, and then this one FA is called as the FARA, which is fuel to air ratio. And then there is another important criteria known as the equivalence ratio. So I have mentioned to you before about the complete combustion, which is complete combustion is achieved when it used the theoretical air. So with that theoretical air or theoretical stoichiometric combustion, which is the perfect combustion for the fuel, but in actual condition, the this perfect air to stoichiometric air to fuel ratio, we produce the stoichiometric or theoretical air to fuel ratio. But air to fuel ratio also can happen when it is incomplete or in the actual combustion. So the ratio between of the air to fuel actual combustion to the air to fuel the stoichiometric combustion is known as the equivalence ratio. Okay. In the industry for the engine development or in the engine setting, this is also known as the lambda. Okay, so this is known as the lambda. Okay, so you can Google lambda for engine, yeah, lambda for engine combustion, which is why this is a lambda is important. If you can imagine that if you are riding a motorcycle in the morning, which is the motorcycle is difficult to be started, then what you need to do is that to open the choke of your carburetor or for your engine. So when you open this choke, which is actually it will increase the diameter of the throttling area, and it will absorb or it will get in more what call that the dry air, the air into the your cylinder. So when more air coming into the cylinder, there will be more possibilities for the engine, for the mixture between the fuel and the air. So with that, the engine will be able to be started. But the problem is that it is happen not at the lambda equal to 1.0, but the lambda will be increased because the amount of air that is absorbed into the engine will be getting larger. So some of the unreacted oxygen and will be produced through the exhaust. Okay, so that is for the lambda, and then yeah, so this one you can just do it at home. Okay, so this one you can do calculation lepas ni sendirilah ya. And then this is the theoretical combustion, which is it give you the minimum required of air to complete the combustion process. So even this one pun ada di chemical reaction. So in actual practice, combustion process use more air than stoichiometric to increase the combustion efficiency as well as temperature control procedure. Okay, so masuk temperature control procedure ni, which is when the engine is operated at high RPM. So because you require more power for the engine, so you tekan you push the throttle, and then the engine will ramp up, naik ke tinggi, BMEP also is increased, and as well the power also will be increased. But the temperature will be getting higher. So if you maintain the lambda at the 1.0, what will happen is that the sudden increase of temperature due to the high power produced, the temperature in the combustion chamber or in your cylinder also will be increased, then it will damage or the reliability of the engine will be reduced. So what is required by the engine here is that to reduce the temperature. So how to reduce the temperature is that there will be more fuel will be injected into the engine. So which means that the lambda value will be decreased because more fuel will be injected into your engine. So with more fuel, the combustion will be deteriorated, but still the power output still will be higher because of the high RPM engine. And then the combustion temperature will be decreased due to more fuel is injected into the combustion chamber. So this will be reduce the damage of the will be increase the reliability of the of your engine. Okay, so this is one of the aspect, the control measurement of the lambda process. Okay, so how this lambda be controlled? It is actually by reading into the engine control unit dalam you punya engine, dalam in the vehicle or in the car. So ECU, which is required many parameters X, Y, Z, then A, B, C, something like that, and then it will also produce FX control. So with this, which is actually this is a control parameters, which is getting the reading from the variables. So all these variables, such as for example the engine speed, the mass flow rate, and then as well with the temperature. So it will read throughout the map, and it will do have some calculation in here, which is all the mathematical calculation, translating all these sensors, reading all the variables, and then give an input to the engine control unit so that it will give the control analysis to the driver. So, or sometimes most of the time, which is actually if we give direct sense, I mean direct control to the engine. Okay, so this is throughout the engine, yeah, where the some of the control process, for example, the amount of the fuel that has to be injected into the engine, all of this running through this the process is automatic, which is by reading the map, okay, by reading the engine map, what is required here, and then translate it into the mathematical formulation through the map, and then we give the signal processing to the electromechanical devices and control some of the like, for example, your throttling valve, your what else, the injection, the amount of the injector, the injection of the fuel, okay. So this kind of thing, which is coming control automatically by the ECU, and then the user interface control, like for example the handling, the driving, the steering, and then as well the throttling valve that been pushed or released by the driver. Okay, so the excess of air is in term of the when the combustion air is supplied greater than psychrometric 0%, when excess of air is equal to 100%, or 50% when excess of air is 150% of the psychrometric air. But there also deficiency of air, which is air deficiency, or we call it as the stuff of air. So this is happen when the amount of fuel is larger than the amount of the air from the psychrometric combustion. So this is also happen when you boleh baca lah dalam sini, ya, when I mentioned before about the lambda process, lambda setting at the high temperature. Okay, so this is a combustion analysis where we're going to look on the to achieve the complete combustion required the supply of the excess air. Combustion analysis, dry air with the moisture content, which is also we're going to look later on. Okay, this is a, if you can recall, the atmospheric pressure, atmospheric air from the last air conditioning class, yeah? Atmospheric air is contained of the dry air plus moisture, kan? So this dry air is also presented by PA, and this is presented by PV. Nah, yang ni yang kita tengok. Okay, PA PV, which is equal to mass of air bahagi dengan mass of saturated. Okay, there where you have the relative humidity. Okay, and then the P also due to the Dalton's law can be calculated from that one. And the dry air, it is contained of the O2 plus 3.76 N2, okay, plus number of mole for air, for sorry, number of mole is not air kat sini, is a V, which is H2O. So this is a water ataupun H2O. Okay, so this is the, yeah, so we going to air to fuel ratio. Bukan, kita tak, kita not going to look for this example. You can do it at home. Yang ni with the chemical combustion. Yang ini pun kita akan tengok later on for natural gas, ya. Yeah? Natural gas kita akan tengok juga nanti. And then this is octane. This is analysis, simple analysis. Okay, so this is the second part, which is the energy analysis. So energy analysis, we're going to use with the first law of thermodynamics, where the change of energy in the system plus change of energy in the state and the chemical changes. So in energy analysis, we're going to define at the standard reference, where the standard reference is at 25 degrees Celsius and 1 atmosphere. So we're going to use the table A27 yang saya suruh you buka tadi tu, which is we're going to use this table, a standard reference, which is writing as H0 referring to the standard reference. S0, U0, which is this is referred to 25 degrees Celsius, 1 atmosphere. Okay? Enthalpy of reaction, Hg, is the difference between the enthalpy of product at a specified state and the enthalpy of reactant at the same state in the complete combustion, where the enthalpy of combustion is the changes between the total summation of H product minus summation of H reactant. Okay, so which is given by this one. Okay. So in energy analysis standard, okay, sama ulang-ulang nanti dia. So tadi bukan Hg ya, tapi kita buka enthalpy of formation. Okay, so what is enthalpy of formation? Enthalpy of formation is the amount of the energy that is required to form the substance. So for the substance such as N2O2, which is considered as the stable element, the enthalpy of formation for these substances are zero. Okay, so enthalpy of reactant, which is actual combustion, given by HF, enthalpy of formation plus enthalpy of at state minus enthalpy at the reference. Okay, which is given by this equation. So this is sebelah reactant, and then this is for the individual substance, and then this is sebelah enthalpy for the product. Okay, sama je sebenarnya, cumanya this is a summation for the product and this is a summation of the reactant. So what we have to do is that first in the analysis we have to do the we have to do the chemical balance. Satu. And then yang kedua, we can calculate the air to fuel ratio. And then yang ketiga, from this chemical balance, we will identify what will be the number of mole for each substances. Okay? And then after that, you're going to calculate the each component. Okay? Each component. Enthalpy of substance for reactant and product. Yeah. So enthalpy of component, and then lastly you're going to sum up the enthalpy in the component, enthalpy for the component for the reactant and enthalpy for the each component in the product, and then calculate the amount of the enthalpy for this. We're going to look few analysis. So this is my plan. Okay. So this is my plan. So the fuel that we're going to use is C3H8. Okay. So C8H18, so which is this is octane. Okay, this is octane. So what we're going to analyze is satu, we're going to analyze the theoretical combustion ataupun complete combustion. Then we're going to calculate the Q dot. Itu panjang. So complete combustion and then actual combustion. as well. Kita akan calculate the Q dot. And then we going to calculate yang ketiga. We going to do the analysis. That's why yang bahagian combustion ni I required every dua kelas, two synchronous class for every week. Yeah? Sebab the analysis going to be long. Actual combustions, and then after that we going to look for the actual combustion, natural gas. Okay, and then yang keempat, natural gas, which is we going to use for the complete and as well for the actual. And then you're going to use, we're going to look on the solid combustion. Complete and then actual. And then yang kelima, yang tertinggal sepatutnya before we go for the natural gas, we're going to look as well for the combustion with moisture. Okay, which is also going to look dalam complete and as well actual combustion. Okay. So, this combustion with moisture also can happen dekat natural gas, solid and as well liquid. Okay. So, this is a type of fuel. Combustion. Kalau kita masukkan dalam table tu pun boleh nampak juga what will happen. Natural ni, complete, and then finally the analysis with the gas analyzer. So in the gas analyzer, what will happen is that the measurement through the product. Okay. So in the gas analyzer, the product or the exhaust analysis, guess you can Google apa dia masuk dia gas analyzer. Nah, ada product for gas analyzer, which is it will measure the mole fraction for exhaust substance. So daripada exhaust substance tu, we do the reverse combustion analysis. Kita dapatkan produk dulu, baru kita cari reactant punya size. So kalau dalam normal punya analisis daripada reactant, and then we do the calculation for the product. Okay, and then we do the chemical balance. Yeah. So in overall, sebenarnya kalau kita ambil yang the cases yang kat sini, theoretical, and then you have the actual, then you have the apa nama tu, satu lagi the what else? Moisture, M. Yeah. So it can be happen dengan satu lagi with this gas analyzer. Okay. So this is can be happen with the liquid. This is happen dengan gas and also happen dengan solid. Okay. So kalau kita tengok ada berapa, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Maybe about 12 analysis that can be involved dalam kita punya kelas ni. Okay, so banyak many processes that or many analysis that can be done through this combustion analysis. Okay, so let's look yang pertama, this one which is we just use with the liquid octane, where this liquid octane enter to the combustion chamber at 25 degrees Celsius and 1 atmosphere, injected into the combustion chamber, air enter the combustion chamber at 310 Kelvin at the rate of 120 gram per second. The exit temperature of the combustion product is 1000 Kelvin. So assuming the combustion is complete and the water exit as a vapor, determine the mass flow rate of the fuel, the rate of the, which means that you kena dapatkan di A, air to fuel ratio, ya, AF. AFR. A apa dia? Dia punya singkatan AF, air to fuel ratio. A up. And then calculate the Q dot, the rate of heat transfer from the combustion chamber. Okay. So, start from here, tolong buka property table sekali dengan yang ini, dengan this note. So, what we have here dalam schematic, which is, this is a combustion chamber. So, ada soalan tak before kita masuk? Ada tak? So, this is the air and this is the fuel. Fuel yang kita gunakan, liquid. No, tak pakai yang tu. Kita gunakan this one. C8H18 liquid. Yeah. And then here, kita akan gunakan O2 plus 3.76 N2. And then we going to calculate the theoretical air. Okay, masuk dalam combustion chamber, which is, this is the temperature 25 degrees Celsius and this is the 310 Kelvin, yeah, T for the fuel, which is produce, this is the complete, which is you're going to produce X CO2 plus Y H2O plus Z N2, okay, which is, this is the product at 1000 Kelvin. Yang ni reactants. Sebenarnya tak muat lah. Okay. So, first we have to do the chemical balance. Okay. So, the chemical balance that will be involved is the 1 kilomole of the C8H18. So, 1 kilomole kita tak tulis lah. So, C8H18 plus ATH tadi kan, yang I write down yang kat bawah tadi. O2 plus 3.76 N2 produce X CO2 plus Y H2O plus Z N2. Okay. So, we have to do the chemical balance dahulu for to define what will be the amount of the theoretical air. Okay, so pertamanya kita ambil yang mana yang paling senang. Kita ambil yang X dulu ya. Nampak tak? Tukar ya. Kita ambil X. And then after that, kita buat bahagian Y. And then A. And then Z. Okay. So, kita softkan C dahulu, carbon. Okay, carbon. Which is, carbon kat sini C8 ya. Sebelah sini, 8, which is 8, 1 plus. Sini ada tak carbon? Tak ada ya. Dekat air, tak ada carbon. Ini pun salah ya. Kita kena tulis 1 darab 8 macam tu. And then produce X 1. Okay, which mean that X is equal to 8. Okay. And then after carbon, kita pergi kepada hydrogen. H. So, hydrogen, kat sini ada berapa? 18 kan? So, hydrogen 2, sorry, hydrogen, ya, yeah, 29 ataupun 18. Sini tak ada. Sebelah bahagian dry air tidak ada hydrogen, which is produce Y 2, okay? Which is Y is equal to 9. Okay, so that's hydrogen. And then A. Oh ya, yeah, kita boleh. sini ada sock, kita boleh buat untuk oksigen. Okey, oksigen O, hidrogen tadi H2 eh. Sepatutnya kali dengan 2 tadi kat dalamnya. Balik. Okey. So, sini ada oksigen tak ada. So, oksigen ATH sebelah reaktan theoretical tarap dengan 2. And then X O2 ada 2 plus YH2O. YH2O ni yang satu eh. So X kita dah tahu 8. Y 9. Okay. So 8 kali 2 16 ya. So 8 kali 2 16. 16 campur 9 berapa? 16 campur 9 20. 20 16 campur 9 25. 25 bahagi 2 jadi ATH sama dengan 12.5. Okey.
Ya. Yeah. Yang dekat hidrogen tu kenapa 2 darab 9? Kalau kita satu
Selalunya boleh juga sebab selalunya hidrogen ni dia wujud dalam substance H2. Boleh je. Kalau which is actually kat sini pun akan jadi 18 juga, balance juga. Ya. Yeah? Selalunya nomenklatur hidrogen ni duduk sebagai H2. Ya. Yeah? Selalu nomenklatur dia duduk macam tu. Okay. So that's hydrogen. Sorry, that's for the ATH. So we know that 1 kilomole of octane will be react with 12.5 kilomole of ni. This one, dry air. And then it will produce 8 kilomole of carbon dioxide, 9 kilomole of H2O plus Z kilomole of N2O. So N2 nitrogen N. So N2 ATH kita dah dapat 12.5. N2 2 kali dengan 3.76. 2 kali 3.76 berapa jawapan dia? 2 darab dengan Z darab dengan 2. So Z is equal to berapa tu? 12.5. 12.5 kali dengan 3.76. 47 eh. Okay. So our chemical balance C8 H18 plus 12.5 O2 plus 3.76 N2 will produce 8 tadi 8 CO2 plus 9 H2O plus berapa? 14.5 ya? 47 N2 ya? Yeah? So this is a chemical balance. Okay, so dah balance lah kalau you kira apa semua tu, this is a balance. So from here, we calculate the air to fuel ratio, AF. Air to fuel ratio. So air to fuel ratio is the mass of air divided by mass of fuel. Okay, so mass of air. Mass of air, macam mana nak kira? Mass of air sama dengan, dia ada 12.5. The number of mole dia sama dengan 4.76 mole. Okay. And then, mass dia berapa? 28. You boleh tengok dekat table. Table kat depan tu. Which is 28.97 kilogram per kilomole of air. Okay. 28.97. Okay. And then divided by mass of fuel, molar mass of fuel, which is C8H18. C Si dia punya molar mass dia berapa? Untuk 1 kilomol. Berapa? Dia 1 kilomol kali dengan C8, 8 C12 kan? 8 kali 12. Molar mass untuk karbon 12, 8 untuk number of mole kat situ. Number of molecule plus berapa? 2 kali dengan 9. Sama. Hidrogen dia 1. Okay. So you boleh dapat lah. So this is going to be air to fuel ratio. Boleh kira ni? Dapat? Ada? 12.5. 28.97 ni ada dalam table ya. Ada dalam table. 12.5 kali dengan 4.76 kali dengan 28.97. 1723.715. Bahagi dengan, so this is a kilogram. Bahagi dengan berapa tu? 8 kali 12 berapa? 66 campur dengan 18. Berapa? 114 kan? Ha. Jadi berapa? 17 berapa? Berapa?
15.12
ya. So bermakna what does it mean here? For 1 kilomol, so for 1 kilogram of air, sorry, for 1 kilogram of fuel, there will be 15.12 kilogram of air. Itu maksud dia. So, kalau di saya bagi tu air kan? The mass flow rate of air kan? Ke fuel saya bagi kat you. M dot tu. M dot saya bagi fuel ke air? M dot air kan? Sama dengan 120 gram per second. Which mean that M dot of air, sorry, M dot of fuel equal to M dot of air dia bahagi dengan AF. Okay, air to fuel ratio. Yeah, yeah. Which is berapa tu? 120 gram per second bahagi dengan 15.12. Berapa? You boleh dapat mass flow rate of the fuel.
7.93
gram per second untuk fuel. Okay. So baru kita okay, satu. Reactants, product. Ini substance. Eh? Okay. So satu kita, first we going to look on the value n there. Okay. N. And then we're going to look on the enthalpy of formation, NF, sorry, HF, enthalpy of formation, HF. Lepas tu, enthalpy dekat, dia punya enthalpy at state. Dekat berapa state dia tadi? Satu dekat, ya, yeah, enthalpy state. Lepas tu, enthalpy dekat, tak cukup ke ni? Enthalpy dekat apa nama value dia? Enthalpy dekat H, semua ada ni lah kat atas ni HT, and then this is H reference dekat 25 degree Celsius. Lepas tu, this is the NHF minus
HT tolak dengan H not. Okey. Ada sini pun sama. HF. Yang ni produk berapa degree Celsius dia? Yang ni 310 Kelvin kan? Yang ni produk dia 1000 Kelvin. Okey. So jadi HT enthalpy dekat T dia HT dekat ni lah dekat 1000 and then this is H reference and then this is the N enthalpy formation minus enthalpy state tolak dengan enthalpy reference. Okay. So first kita akan tengok kepada C8H18. C8H18 here. So number of mole dia sama dengan 1. Enthalpy of formation dia berapa? Cuba tengok table 26 ke 27 something like that. Cuba buka. Cuba buka table 26. Ah, enthalpy of formation.
C8H18
kan? Ha, C8H18 liquid.
363.
363 berapa?
363
ratus ribu kan? Ratus ribu tu. Minus kau positif. Positif. Okey. Enthalpy dekat enthalpy dekat sini tak ada, enthalpy sini tak ada. So 363 kali dengan 1 363 000. Okey. Dekat produk dia tak ada. Okey. Alright, lepas itu you tengok dekat O2. O2. Tadi O2 berapa tadi? Number of mole dia 12.5 kan? Dekat reactant 12.5. Enthalpy of formation for O2 ada tak? Kosong kan? Okay. Enthalpy of reactant dekat 310 degree. Buka table dekat, you tengok dekat header dia. Tengok dekat O2. Cari 310 degree Celsius Kelvin. Ada tak? Ada.
Apa tadi nak cari H
eh? O2 O2.
O2 dekat tepi dia 300
kan? Ha, dekat 310. Ha. 3110.
Dekat table 24 ni rasa yang ada 300.
Yang ada 310. Ya kat situ ada 300 ke 310? 320. Dia naik 10 10 10 tu.
Yang ada ni 300.
300. Lepas 300 berapa?
500.
Tak ada, bukan yang tu. Lepas 300 500 tu tak betul. Ni salah tengok tempoh tu.
Oh ni.
A18 ke? Ha? Ha, A18 ke something like that. Dia lepas pada table N2.
Dia punya H ni H tu.
O2 O2. Oh.
Tu 300 rasa.
Ha, 310.
310.
Yeah.
H dia 9030.
Ha. 9030 kan? Okey, 9030. Okey, kita boleh ada dulu sikit. 9030. Okey, H dekat 298. 298 tu dekat 25 degree Celsius lah. Kat atas dia je. Ha, atas dia je.
8682.
Okey. So jadi you guna kira ni 12.5 kali dengan 9030 tolak 8682 dan you dapat nilai kat sini. Okey. dekat reactor, dekat produk tak ada O2 kan? Nanti kalau actual ada tau. Okay, sebab tu lah. Okay. Lepas O2 kita tengok N2. N2 tadi berapa? N2? 12.5 kali 3.76 ya. Sama dengan 47. Samalah. Okay. N2, enthalpy of formation untuk N2 pun kosong. Buka entable N2 pula. Dekat 310 Kelvin. Berapa nilai dia?
Sepuluh, 9014.
25 degree Celsius, 298.
8669.
Okey, somebody tolong kira yang bahagian sini berapa? So, Syafiq kira kat sini.
12.5 darab
90-30
tolak
8682. Ya, 12.5 dalam kurungan cara dia kira ya. Ini 12.5 darab kurungan HF tak ada kan. So 9030 tolak 8682. Ha, macam tu. Yang ni pun sama. 47 darab 9014 tolak 8669. Ha, macam tu lah. Okay.
Dan auto 4350.
Ya. 4350. Yang ini?
16215.
16215. Okay. Dekat N2 kat sini pun ada ya. Dekat sini ada 47. HF tak ada, enthalpy formation. HT kena tengok dekat 1000. Cuba tengok dekat 1000. Bad Badaria, cuba tengok dekat 1000. Berapa tu?
Untuk apa?
Untuk N2. N2 dekat 1000. Tiga kosong satu dua sembilan. Tiga kosong satu dua sembilan kan? Okey. Dekat 298 8669. Okey. So jadi dekat situ you kena calculate juga lah. Berapa tu? 47 kali dengan 30129 tolak 8669. Ha, dapatlah berapa? Okey. Ha, masukkan kat sini. Ya. Yeah. And then you ada lagi value untuk apa ni? N2 dekat produk pula. N2 apa? Ni dah habis. Produk CO2. CO2. CO2 tadi berapa? N dia number of mole 8 kan? Buka table 26 ke 27. Tengok enthalpy of formation untuk CO2. Tengok enthalpy of formation untuk CO2. Minus 249 ke berapa? Buka table tu.
Table 26, sir.
Table 26. 26 ke 27, something like that.
393520.
Ha, okey, negatif 393
520.
520 ya. Okey. And then buka table CO2 pula yang dekat belah-belah. Ke 20 sambil like that. Cari table CO2. Cari table CO2.
CO2 dekat 1000 kan, sir?
Ha, yes. CO2 dekat 1000.
30355.
Berapa?
30355.
Okey. Dekat 298?
29693.
Berapa?
29693.
Ha, okey. So, jadi untuk CO2, CO2 8 kali dengan apa ni? Minus 393520 plus 3031355 tolak 29693. Baru tutup. Faham tak ni? Boleh nampak? Okay. CO2 lepas tu H2O kan? Dihasilkan apa lagi? H2O kan? H2O dihasilkan kat sini. H2O tadi berapa? 9 kan? 9. Tengok enthalpy of formation untuk H2O. Table A26. Nak habis kelas dah sejam lebih dah ni.
Negatif 285830.
285830. Okey, yang kat situ.
H2O 1000.
Sekejap 285830. Okey, berapa ni?
Dia hasilkan water ke water vapor?
Ah, dia hasilkan water vapor. Jadi saya cakap dia kan? H2O negatif 241820. Okey. 241820. Okey. Yang ni berapa? Tengok table H2O. Okey, 35. Okey, yang ini dekat 298. Tapi dia betul yang ni 29693 ni tinggi sangat rasanya value-nya. Yang dekat CO2 ni. Betul lah. Tengok dekat temperature 298.
Oh, 298 H2O 9904.
Itulah, saya rasa kecil je 9904 kan. Sorry, yang ini
H2O 9904.
9904. Cuba tambah balik. The summation of reactant. Berapa? Summation of reactants. Cuba kira balik. Yang saya tulis tadi salah kan? Cepat sikit lagi. Yang ni 3 berapa? Negatif berapa? Produk tadi dah ada kan? 391.
4190.
4. Okey. Yang ini? Reactant?
Negatif 187.
Okey.
885.
Okey. So formula dia apa tadi? Formula dia H sama dengan enthalpy of product. Tolak kan? Enthalpy of Reaktan. Okey, pandai. Good. Okey, sama dengan minus 3914190 tolak, jadi tambah kat situ.
Jadi tambah.
187885. Okey. Berapa tu?
Tambah 391190. 3726.
37 minus 3726.
Okey.
Eh, tidak sih. Sudah.
3025 ya. Kilojoule. Negatif 3726 305.
Okay, alright. So yang ni value dia dalam kilojoule per kilomol tau. Okay, which is unit dia dalam bentuk ni. Bila ada tanda kat atas ni, which means that unit dia dalam kilomol. So kalau nak tukar kepada kilojoule per kilogram, which is minus 3726305 kilojoule kilomol of fuel ni tau, of C8H18. 12 kali 8 berapa tadi? 12 kali 8 96 campur 18 114 kan. So kilomol, jadi darabnya kilogram, 1 kilogram, okey, 1 kilomol, 1 kilomol sama dengan 114 kilogram. Okey. Ha tu. Jadi 3726 305 bahagi dengan 114. Ha tu. Okey. So berapa tu dapat tu?
Negatif 3268
3628
3268
32. Okey, 3268 eh. 3268
6.88.
6.88. Okey. Ni unit dia dalam kilojoule per kilogram. Ha, tapi Q dot is equal to H kali dengan M dot of U, which is sama dengan negatif 3286.88 kilojoule kilogram of C8H18 times dengan berapa tadi kita punya mass flow rate tadi? Berapa tadi? Mass flow rate kita?
0.93.
Ha?
7.93
ya. 7.93 gram tau.
Ha.
Gram per second. Maknanya you kena bahagi dengan 1000. Dapatlah.
0.93
tu bagi 1000 saja. Ha, yalah dalam gram. Yang ni dalam kilogram kan? Unit dia.
Okey.
Ha, 7 point, ha, dapatlah tu. Berapa? 259.
Negatif 259.44.
0.44 eh? Kilo watt.
Watt.
Okay, inilah dia the amount of rate of heat produced from the combustion process. You can see that from the bila you ada, if you going to throttle, kan? If you going to throttle, if If you imagine this is your car, the engine of your car, you tekan dia minyak, and then the speed sensor untuk throttle tu akan terbuka. So speed sensor terbuka, then it will read the flow rate of the fuel. Dibaca. Okay. So apa yang the sensor will tell is that you are going to maintain the engine at the thermometric combustion ataupun theoretical combustion. So for the theoretical combustion, it required the ratio of 15.1 the mass flow rate untuk air. So untuk 15.1 dia akan buka dia punya valve untuk you punya engine tu. So valve engine tu akan terbuka, bukan valve untuk air intake tau. Bukan valve untuk dekat silinder, tapi valve dekat dia punya throttle untuk opening tu yang masuk nanti. So yang itu akan di limited. So dia akan masuk coming, and then it will change the conditions. Okay? Ataupun it also can sense dekat that particular speed the fuel, the mass flow rate yang masuk tu with berapa dia punya sensor dia. Okay? Dia punya the flow rate of the air coming. So with that flow rate of the air coming, it will sense balik dekat the mass flow rate untuk fuel, berapa banyak yang diperlukan oleh fuel untuk injected into that particular engine, so that the amount of engine output we produce at this much. Okay? So this is intelligently calculate and putting together di dalam you punya engine control unit lah. Okay? So for the next class, kita akan tengok actual combustion pula. Yeah. So see you on Wednesday. Yeah.